At Learn That Word, you can request your own words and have the quiz focus on those. Our database offers 150,000 fully edited words, along with audio, images, usage samples, translations, and so on. Students can add words to their own account, or teachers can send words to all the students in a class. The process is largely the same, and I will show both in this video. Students simply scroll down their portal page. First, we'll search for an existing list in our archive. Let's say you are looking for words of Latin origin. You could also search for lists that were added by your account or school if you want. The table shows all lists that contain the word Latin. You can sort this list, which consists of more than one page, by clicking on the column's name. For example, you might want to look for the list with the highest rating. Click on the title, and it takes you to the page for that list. Please remember that you are really helping the community of learners by submitting as much information as possible whenever you make a list. Down here are the words, and they're broken up into units of about 30 words. Clicking Show Words lets me see the words. Seems like just the list I'm looking for. By clicking Bookmark up here, I link it for direct access from my portal. I also rate it to share my assessment with others. If you wanted to make changes to the list, you could click the Modify This List button. If this is a list that was created by you, your edits will update the existing list. If someone else created this list, a copy of the list is created with your modifications. Then I click Add This List, next to the unit I would like to add to my quiz. It is better to add units one by one and not multiple units at once. Learning comes from the regular review of your practice words, which come up only after any words added have been studied. So if you add too many words at once, your practice word review will be delayed. The process will take longer and produce results slower. Now select if the words should be added to the beginning or end of your preferred words, and you're done. Back in your portal, you'll see the recent word list bookmarked, so you can return to it easily. You also see the words you just added listed in the active preferred words list. Next, let's look at how the Add Words feature works in the teacher portal. First, click on the names of the class you want to add words to. The class expands so you see all the students. Of course, you can also verify that it's the intended class by looking at the title. Click the Add Words button. Words are always sent to the entire class. If you want to send words to just a few students, you need to create a class and give the key for that class to only those students. Creating classes is always free, and students can be in as many classes as needed. There are three options when you want to create your own word list: via spreadsheet upload, which we'll explore later, or by entering either words only, or by entering word definition pairs. Please try to add as much information as you can about your list. If it's relating to a book, please pick up the ISBN number from the cover of the book so people can easily locate it. Regardless if you're using the work of someone else or your own, please clearly identify the list, its intention, and give credit to the author. You can enter links to interactive resources. A rich list archive is an asset to everybody, so please choose the default Share This List here. Next drop-down lets you choose if you want to only create this list or also want it added to your quiz at the same time. Here is how you add words. Easy enough. Let's see how to enter a word/definition list. In this option, you can add your own definitions, comments, or usage samples to the list. Just make sure that it does not contain the word in question. These custom definitions are available during the quizzes by moving the mouse over this icon. You can number chapters and name units if you like. If you don't, the program will automatically create units of about 30 words. This is done to avoid adding too many words at once, which would delay your review of practice words. Ideally, practice word review should happen in each session. Okay, the list was successfully submitted. Let's modify it now. We could click on Edit to update the first chapter, but let's add a new chapter. Click Submit. In this update, two words were not found in the database and they're listed in red. The first one is a typo, and the second is the plural, browns, of a regular word, brown. Normally, variations of words are only included if they're irregular. If a word is not found in the database, try entering its base form, so brown instead of browns. Our editors review words that create an error message to see if some of them need to be added. Okay, we'll just modify the list again and add the words in correct format. We click Add More Words and enter what's missing. Now let's look at how you upload word lists in a spreadsheet. If you do that, you don't have to enter any information online. You enter it all in the spreadsheet and then upload it. This is great if you already have the information in digital format, where you can just copy and paste it. Using a spreadsheet lets you prepare lists offline and upload them quickly. Click here to download our template. Using this template will make it work with the archive database. Open the template and before doing anything else, save it in a convenient location with a name that makes sense to you. Select Comma Separated File or .csv as the file format. This is important because the archive only accepts files with the CSV extension. Others will cause errors. Now you enter the information just like you would online. If you want to create multiple chapters and units, you just copy the entire blue area, containing the chapter and unit area in open space below, both columns, and paste them below to add more. Just like this. Now we save the file and go back online. Choose File. Select the file just created, click Upload, and you're done.